What is going on, peeps? Welcome to our fourth episode of Character Wars, powered by Mugen. Well, first off, if you haven't done so already, please check out the special Character Wars episode that I put up on the 4th of July, Independence Slay. Kind of had some my featured battles, I guess we could say, because episode 5, well, we'll see this week. It features a lot of user-requested battles here. But before we get to the battles, I kind of want to throw out my shout-outs here this week, and I want to send thanks out to Meadwise. He sent us some super good characters here. We got like Adele, we got Ruji Yamazaki from him, Guile, Keo 13. We got a faction known as the Southside Crime Syndicate. He sent me A-Rock, and then we got Tokino Mia, Kenshiro, and the real version of Kira Blossom here. Wee Cloud, he sent me over several new patched AI fighters, including his team, the Wiccan, so I think we'll see them in action in tonight, in fact, here. We also have Silent Dawn, also known as Neon Chaos 711. He sent me over Ignis, Scarlet, and Broly this week. And TK and Neo Mega Man, of course, they loaded me up with plenty of characters there from their roster. So, yeah, our roster is now full, folks. So if you want to add a character to the roster, you can still submit me requests. However, now I'm going to have to kind of evaluate, and I'll have to replace characters on the roster there. So if you have a character you want to replace, tell me who you want to see him try to battle to, like, take their spot, essentially. And as long as those fights aren't too bad or too all, like, S-tier versus F-tier or something like that, then I'll probably make them happen. And anyhow, kind of rambling on here. So the five requests that I'm going to feature here this week, it looks like we have Brandon Johnson's request for his team, Project Doomsday. They're going to be in 4v4 action against Team Eddie. Then we got WeCloud, who has two of his new fighters here. It's Lou and Kuon. They're slated to fight Magneto and Dr. Doom, but we'll see if that happens, folks. Doom and... you never know what that's going to happen with them. Then we got Peace Guy, who wanted to see the Kung Fu Man, Liu Kang, team up with Jin Cosma this week to battle Vegeta, Goku, and Piccolo. We have Amid Wise that has Keo 13 and Ogre teaming up to battle Wall. We got Punk Banaga, Nobunaga, and CM Punk, but who knows? They're like Magneto and Dr. Doom. A lot of these teams, they might try to duck their opponents. Only time will tell, folks. Then we have a special 4v4 request there. It's going to feature by Random Pros, who wanted to see Dark Donald, Dark Makai, Dark Ernie, and Dark Donald battle, well, an S-tier team of my choosing, so you'll have to see who I picked on that one. And a note on that one, folks, if you're easily scared of the Screamers, round two of that battle, right before it starts, you better brace yourself. I won't spoil it there, but we got something that might scare the little ones there. So, anyhow, I digress, folks. I've rambled on enough. Let's send it to the steel cage for our first battle of episode 4. Up next, we've got a 3v3 battle that was requested by Peace Guy. He wanted to see the Kung Fu Man and Liu Kang team up with Jin Cosma to battle Vegeta, Goku, and Piccolo, Team DBZ! In some form, I should say. Well, Team DBZ, they have various members, and just like Team Marvel, Team X-Men, and Team DC, kind of interchangeable parts there, anyhow. Let's see. Official debut, I believe, of Jin Kazuma, and is it Piccolo's a Piccolo? Anyhow, early on, our DBZ Warriors just getting absolutely locked down. Vegeta getting pounded. Goku trying to defend here, but Kung Fu Man, Jin, and Liu Kang, absolutely astonishing here. Finally, Piccolo and DBZ getting out of there, I should say. Team DBZ in a bad hole as Vegeta's knocked out. It's Goku and Piccolo trying to fight off Liu Kang. And, well, they're doing their best as Jin Kazuma using his range off. Piccolo and Goku doing well as a team here. The Mega Kamehameha wave launched. I don't think... yeah, that took out the Kung Fu Man. Oh, no, he's still fighting by his skin of his teeth. Goku gets him there, though, folks, and Goku's going to work on Liu Kang. Jin Kazuma and Liu Kang still standing here. I think Jin's down. It's Liu Kang trying to finish off Goku and Piccolo, but he couldn't do it. Goku and Piccolo stay alive after Vegeta got crushed there. Anyhow, round two underway with Jin getting behind our DBZ Warriors. Goku teleports out. Vegeta already in a bad hole here. So Liu Kang tosses Vegeta into the fray there. Kung Fu Man using his ranged abilities tosses Piccolo there as Liu Kang gets smacked knocked down by Piccolo. On the other side, Jin Cosmo gets tossed by Goku as Kung Fu Man doing his best to get back in there and help out his team, doing the double team on Piccolo and Vegeta. Vegeta tries to unleash an energy wave, gets KO'd for his trouble. Goku being pinned down. Looks like Jin Cosmo was KO'd somewhere in the fray as well, folks. Goku double team is Piccolo, well, trying to get back in it, powers up, big energy blast, he's going to blow up on the Kung Fu Man. However, Kung Fu Man and Liu Kang doing their best to even it up. Goku, well, down to Goku and the Kung Fu Man. Kung Fu Man trying to save his team here. Goku gets tossed, teleports, big punch combo. Kung Fu Man locked in the corner, and just like that, Team DBZ takes it in consecutive rounds.
If you start to hate me, hate your destination just as I do.
Well, I don't know why Vegeta hates where he has to go anyhow. But he definitely gets a win, even though he got knocked out in both rounds. We saw a pretty impressive request there, and I certainly hope you all enjoyed that one. Well, it was a rough day there, but I'm sure we'll see a bounce back for Liu Kang, Kung Fu Man, and Jin Cosmo as well there, folks. Again, I certainly hope you all enjoyed that battle. Thanks again there, Peace Guys, for sending that one in. And up next, we will have another request battle. Up next, it's 2v2 action, a request battle that was sent in by WeCloud himself, who wanted to see a couple of the Wiccans debut here. It's Liu and Sumeragi Kuon. Well, originally they were slated to take on Dr. Doom and Magneto, but apparently Doom and Magneto will not accept the challenge until Liu and Kuon have battled other opponents using their, established status. So we're going to see him take on a new team in Hornet Man and Tornado Man. You may have seen them around on TK's show. Well, doing double duty again here. Like I say, these open character exchanges allow these characters to battle across many different series here. Well, Hornet Man and Tornado Man retooled here, looking for a big impact early on. Well, Liu and Kuon doing their best to keep Hornet Man knocked out here. Tornado Man using his ranged offense here, which actually does pretty good to hurt Kuon, I should say. But he's using his ranged abilities as Liu gets in there. All up in Hornet Man's grill there. Tornado Man clearly has the health advantage here, been buffed up a little bit using his Tornado Wind, but Liu and Kuon just tripping up Tornado Man here. It looks like it's just a little bit before the inevitable here, folks. And yes, just like that, down and out. Hornet Man and Tornado Man just absolutely getting wrecked there in round one. Round two, and Kuon and Liu unleashing the flurry of offense to end things here. Tornado Man and Hornet Man just absolutely stunlocked here. Hornet Man nearly KO'd. That's it for him. Liu unleashing the flurry. Hornet Man, or Tornado Man, hangs on by a thread, but then Liu stabs him down. And wow. Liu and Kuon just destroying Tornado Man and Hornet Man in their debut. And well, Tornado Man and Hornet Man, back to the drawing board for them. They're going to have to hit the gym seriously, train up here if they want to see some victories on any shows, I guess, here, folks. And well, Liu and Kuon, I don't think Dr. Doom and Magneto are going to be able to dodge that challenge much longer, folks. Like I say, I'm sure we're going to see Liu and Kuon get a hold of Doom and Magneto at some point in the series. When? Only time will tell them. Well, I certainly hope you enjoyed your request, sir, WeCloud. And up next, Character Wars will continue with more battles. Character Wars continues. Up next, we have a 2v2 request that was sent in by Amid Wise, who wanted to see a couple of the characters he sent me there. Keo 13 and Ogre team up here. They were originally scheduled to challenge CM Punk and Nobunaga, but I guess Punk and Nobunaga not wanting any part of Keo 13 and Ogre, absolutely refusing it here. So we had to search the roster here, folks, and, well, making the jump from the Random Mugen series to the Character Wars series, it's Omega Tiger Woods and Zeke H. Bomb returning to action here. And, well, Keo 13 and Ogre, being an S-tier team, should face an appropriate opponent here. I would rate Punk Nobunaga maybe B-plus to A at the highest, so it wouldn't be much of a challenge for Keo and Ogre, in my opinion, to fight those two, but Well, ZKH Bomb and Omega Tiger Woods returning here. And early on, well, Tiger Woods is getting owned here. Zeke trying to use that grabbing crane. It gets a hold of Keo, drops him down. Zeke using his ranged abilities. Was Tiger Woods already taken out? Yeah, that's it. Spammy offense, and ZKH Bomb down and out, folks. They got him before he could even use his cheap one-shot ability. I can't believe it. Round two underway. And we'll make a Tiger Woods and ZKH Bomb. Immediately, the short bus comes out there. Launches Keo. Mr. Big Shoe stomping Ogre into a pile of goo here. Anyhow, Keo 13 getting in there, taking a chunk of Omega Tiger Woods' health out. But just like that, Zeke still unthreatened and uses his one-shot death bomb. Blows up his opponents in our third and final round underway. Keo and Ogre. Oh, Ogre unleashing his absolute ultimate attack. I think that one-shots Omega Tiger Woods. Zeke left with a fraction. Is he going to get the one-shot off? You know he's thinking about it. Keo grabs him. And, well, I guess he detonated the bomb before he could detonate and kill everybody else there. The old explosive ordnance technique there by Keo 13 takes out ZKH Bomb. And Keo and Ogre successful in their debut. Yeah, I can see why Punkin Nobunaga ran away from that challenge. Who is going to stop this S-tier nightmare? And Omega Tiger Woods and ZKH Bomb, well, I'm sure we haven't seen the last of them, folks. They're not one of these teams that's going to take that loss lightly. I don't know if we might see a rematch. Who knows? They might call it in as soon as next week, determining on well, what happens with time and the likes. Anyhow, up next, we're going to have another battle as Character Wars continues. Up next, we have a user-requested battle sent in by Brandon Johnson, who wanted to see a team he dubs Project Doomsday. It's Chowder, SpongeBob SquarePants, Toothy, and Evil Ronald McDonald teaming up to battle. Well, Team Eddie. It's Eddie from Ed, Ed, and Eddie. It's Mario. It's Luigi and the Kung Fu Man. Let's send it to the cage, folks. Well, the action in this one should be pretty intense. I don't know. Team Project Doomsday got a couple of soft characters in there. Chowder, I don't know. And SpongeBob and Chowder are pretty powerful there. Toothy, obviously the weak link on Project Doomsday here. Well, oh, Fanatum there is Mario Luigi working over Dark Donald. It looks like, well, the Kung Fu Man obliterating SpongeBob and Chowder. Wow, SpongeBob with the SpongeBob Smash trying to get his team back in. Chowder unleashes the jar of stuff there. Mr. Krabs coming out. And finally, it looks like spammy offense being unleashed. Down went Dark Donald. Mario taking the superstar as well. Kung Fu Man gets the best of Toothy and SpongeBob. Just a mega combo unleashed there. And well, Team Eddie takes it in round one in commanding fashion. Eddie and Mario, I don't know how well Kung Fu Man and Luigi were doing there, but we can see that the health in round one could be a continuation here in round two. No much different here. It looks like Project Doomsday getting the best of their opponents early on, at least here. Complete obliteration now as well. I saw somebody get KO'd. Is it Eddie's down and out? Chowder looks like he's next. SpongeBob firing off the ketchup lancer. That catches Mario and Luigi. And Project Doomsday takes round two in commanding fashion. In commanding fashion, I should say. Absolutely brutal, folks. Round three underway. And, well, SpongeBob went for that hyper-interrupted. SpongeBob taking a pounding here. Kung Fu Man unleashing a flurry as Mario hits a big coin combo. Luigi, looks like... Wow, Dark Donald's down. Is it just Toothy and Chowder, the last two standing? Well, that didn't last long. A nearly flawless victory there in round three. And Team Eddie gets what I believe is a colossal upset against Eras Project Doomsday. Well, they had evil Ronald McDonald on their team, but he just was not a powerful enough anchor there, apparently, to outmatch the might and mastery of the Kung Fu Man's brutal skills there. Well, certainly a brutal and awesome 4v4 request there. I hope you enjoyed your battle there, Brandon Johnson. And up next, well, Character Wars is going to continue with more battles. Up next, we have another 4v4 request that was sent in by Random Pros, who wanted to see his team dubbed the Dark Brigade. Well, debut against an S-tier or top-tier team. And well, since he's dark type characters are like beyond top level super characters, like I say, I don't have a lot of stuff that can compete with him. So I came up with one character that might have a chance based on his amount of, I guess, one-shot KOs, and that would be Saitama himself, One Punch Man. He's going to need about three other copies of himself to battle this Dark Brigade. So let's send it to the cage, folks, and see if four One Punch Men can take out, well, the Dark Army of Death here, the Dark Brigade featuring what? We have Dark Ernie, Dark Makai, Dark Colonel, and Dark Ronald. Oh, my goodness, folks. Well, this brutal battle is underway with our One Punch team trying to get one of their combos going. I guess our Dark team having none of that. One of the One Punch Men might have gotten a KO off, but I think it was interrupted. Let's see what happens here. Did the engine crash? No, it didn't crash. We had, was that Dark Colonel get KO'd? Yeah, I think a couple of our characters got KO'd there, but it looks like that Dark Burger was able to do some damage. Well, yeah, it looks like what, Dark Makai and Dark Colonel were taken out there? Well, One Punch Man with the Screamer there waiting for us there. Nothing like that to scare the hell out of everybody to start things off. Well, it doesn't matter. Team One Punch Man, they are down and out, folks. And our Dark Brigade, definitely happy about that. And, well, the Dark Brigade destroys Team One Punch Man. And, well, like I say, folks, not a lot I could say about that. What do we have on the roster that could compare with that? Nothing, really, like I say. And the Dark guys, they'll be guest appearances on Character Wars. Not going to be mainstays, like I say. I can't really have levels of competition to even feed that level of talent there. Anyhow, I certainly hope, Random Pros, you enjoyed your request there, your beatdown request, I should say. And up next, Character Wars will continue with our main event of the evening. Folks, it's time for our main event of the evening. Tonight, it's a 3-versus-3 showdown featuring a new debuting faction. It's A-Rock, Bane, and Charlie Nash. Beatdowns are as easy as ABC is their team name. And they're going to be facing, well, the Powerpuff Girls reuniting here. Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup. Well, let's take it to the Brawl Brothers steel cage for this one, folks. And, well, let's see if beatdowns are as easy as ABC or if it's going to be Team PPG. There we go. Bane arrives, and A-Rock and Charlie Nash good to go here, and immediately, well, Blossom getting knocked back as well. Looks like A-Rock getting worked over by Bubbles here. It's a double team assault there. A-Rock getting knocked back, and well, Buttercup going to work, freezing A-Rock there. Looks like Bane getting the old punch combo as Charlie Nash swings at nothing. So far, ABC getting owned here as an ultimate Bubbles is unleashed. A-Rock nearly KO'd here, folks. I think he's down and out. It looks like Bane and Charlie Nash are still standing here, though. And, well, it looks like Buttercup's been KO'd. So we got two Powerpuff Girls and two people from ABC left here. And, well, Bane and Charlie Nash is in big trouble right now. I think that was the end of Charlie. No, he's still standing here, folks. I thought I heard a KO for sure. Uh-oh, well, who's going to take round one? Bane, well, looks like he's the last member standing, trying to toss Blossom back. She grabs him as I-Beam connects. Just a massive combo being unleashed here. And Bane, well, got the eyes backfire. Is he going to be able to take out Bubbles? Oh, he got her. Can Bane take out a nearly full-power Blossom to save it here? Round one, highly competitive. Blossom looking for the KO since that ice clone out. Looks like Bane taken to the air, comes crashing down. Stunned again, frozen. Oh, ice backfire. Bane getting a big combo going. However, Blossom interrupts, takes Bane up. Bane rolls out of the way. Blossom makes him pay with that eye blast and saves it for Team PPG. Well, beatdowns are as easy as ABC needs to bounce back here in round two. And immediately, well, Charlie Nash getting in there, stunned as well as A-Rock. Bane unleashing his flurry of offense here. And I think we have an ultimate Bubbles being unleashed here. Looks like A-Rock getting that as well as Charlie Nash as well. Buttercup picking up the AK-47, just blasting away here. And Bane, I think he's still unleashing massive fatalities here. Looks like, well, our Powerpuff Girls have been beaten up pretty good, but down with Charlie Nash. It's A-Rock and Bane left standing here. I think, yeah, Bubbles has been taken out. Blossom and Buttercup doing what they can here to take out A-Rock. And Bane left in a handicapped situation once again here. And Blossom and Bubbles just tearing him apart. Beatdowns are as easy as ABC. Looking to spoil the Powerpuff Girls here. Reunion in their debut. And they're just... PPG looks like they have it locked up, folks. Just like that. There you go. Wow. Even after not teaming up for so long, the Powerpuff Girls just able to reunite just like that, folks. And team, yeah, I mean, beatdowns are as easy as ABC. I was running them in off-camera runs. I'd seen them take out some outstanding teams here. So I thought at least we'd get a three-round showdown out of them. A little disappointed there. Back to the drawing board for maybe they need to add a D in there, too, and go try 4v4. I don't know, folks, but I'm sure we haven't seen the last of A-Rock, Bane, and Charlie Nash. They'll bounce back here. Our Powerpuff Girls, congratulations to them on a successful re-debut. And with that being said, folks, we've reached the end of Episode 4 of Character Wars. Certainly hope you all enjoyed the request-heavy episode here this week. Be sure you head over to the forums, submit me your characters. Now that I have a full roster, you're going to have to tell me characters you want to see phased out, and what we'll do is you can basically submit a character you want to challenge a character on my roster for the spot, and I'll kind of look at it. I ain't going to like have D tiers fighting S tiers and stuff like that, so we'll kind of do some balancing, but yeah, still continue to submit me your characters and requests on my Metalocalypse Pro Board forums there, and again, make sure you tune in Saturday for TK's Saturday Mugen show. I know we got Neo on vacation there, and Azure, he's still running his show as well, so be sure you check those out as well, folks. And thanks again for watching. You all have a great rest of your evening.